Alright guys, so we're back with the next episode of the Long Shot Story Mode. We're going to be continuing on from the last point, so let's get it. Hope you all enjoy the video. Devin is clearly famous here.
Trying to get a hold of you today.
Yeah, well, Devin's not coming back to the show. Why are you?
Look, I understand why you left. But if you come back now, there's still time to get the show back on track.
No way. Not with Fountain still there.
I got this, man.
Sorry.
If we work together, we can get the show away from Ross.
What about the Legends game?
It'll be at the end of the season where it should have been all along.
Maybe the two of us though, right?
Yes.
Then I'll do it.
Yeah, well, I will only come back on one condition. And when we get back to Austin, you and I go get dinner together. Just the two of us. Wait a second.
Absolutely not.
Dang.
Okay. I'm still in for the show, though.
All right, well, I guess we'll see you back in Austin.
That old junker will make it there.
I'm searching for him. I sound pretty good with that accent, don't I?
Crazy, man.
Yep, I call this puppy Old Faithful. Never let me down. Come on, Dad, we ain't got all night, baby.
Come, come.
Nice. Wow.
Coach. Devin. Come on in. I wanted to talk with you before we met with the execs. Coach, I just wanted to say that. I'm sorry. I'll go. I just wanted to apologize for leaving. I never should have left. So, I'm sorry. Have a seat. Now, when you got here, I asked why you were on Long Shot. Yeah, I never gave you an answer. Well, because it's a difficult question. You ever wonder why I was here? It's not. Well, you know I was fired by St. Louis, right? Well, years ago, I fought to draft this junior quarterback. This kid had all the talent in the world. He talked to brass and the trading up to get him second overall. Expectations were sky high. My career hung in the balance. Well, I rushed this kid every step of the way. And in my offense, which is predicated on empty backfields, no extra protection, he was a sitting duck. I mean, heck, our favorite play was the deep dig. When he got hurt week one, I hurried him back. And it was all because I had to succeed. I never said this out loud, but what I did, that was abuse. Within 2 years, no team would touch that kid. He was out of the league. Rams fired me. And I told myself that it was because I chose the wrong guy, but the truth is, I was the wrong guy. That kid, deserve better. Look, I came on this show to resurrect my career, to show everybody that the great Jack Ford was back. But a coach's job is to service players, and I violated that. I should have been there for you. I hope that you'll give me another chance, because I'm now ready to do whatever it takes for you to succeed. That is my lone goal going forward. Wow. I really appreciate that, Coach.
You guys ready?
Chose to take a leave of absence, putting the show at risk. Two wrongs, neither right. We all have our reasons, yeah? I've been in this business for a very long time. What I've learned is that there's always room for forgiveness. So it seems that we have two options. Put Julia in charge of Longshot and reassign Ross.
Sir, thank you.
No. Or we just fire Ross outright.
The ratings have been through.
No. I've been sitting here listening to what everybody has to say. The only person I haven't heard from is Devin. Superstar. What's it gonna be?
Devin. I took you off the scrap heap, okay? It's because of me. Every scout out there knows your name. All along, I've been the ally that you never knew you had.
Devin, I know what the coaches want, and you don't owe Ross anything.
These guys may know the coaches, but I know the owners.
Owners? It won't matter if he makes you look like a distraction instead of the talent that you are.
Devin, never, please. I'm begging you, please. I have a house. I have children. Ex-wives.
Okay. So, if he gets reassigned, Julia gets in charge. But if I fire him, what happens to Julia? And that's my thing. I'd rather fire him, to be not gonna lie. I would much be okay with getting rid of him. Oh my goodness. Oh, guys. I think I'm just gonna reassign him. I'll go back and I'll record what happens if he gets fired. Oh, that's a hard decision. I guess I'm just gonna reassign him. I'll record one for you guys showing what happens if I fire him, but yeah, we're gonna.
Ross did create this opportunity.
Exactly. So what I'm hearing is that Julia is the problem.
And Julia.
Julia is my biggest supporter.
Right. No. Exactly. Right. So we should just dump Jack Ford.
Jack's my coach.
What a nice moment for you, Jack. I'm going to let you have it.
Ross, if you have any interest in remaining with this organization, let me tell you, you are pushing it. It'd be wise to zip it now.
Yes, sir. Mr. Brown, sir.
Julia, congratulations, you're the new executive producer of Longshot.
Yay!
Jack, you are Julia's first choice, and now you're mine, babe. Mm-hmm. I'm putting Ross in an advisory role to Longshot, answering to Julia, and if anybody has any issue with this decision, I kindly invite you to gather your things and watch your tuchus on the way out the door.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Stay Congratulations.
Jack.
Coach, good work. Thanks, Coach.
I feel like he's going to cause problems. the dude.
Sorry, you won't regret it.
Oh, I will.
Thank you.
It's a familiar setting.
Hey, ready for me, Coach? Yeah, give me a sec. Cool. Jack, am I too early?
Oh, right on time, Dan. Devin, I want you to meet my good friend, Dan Marino.
Yeah, I really appreciate you being here.
Thrilled to meet you. I'm a big fan.
Ah, that's cool.
Let's see if we can get this kid to loosen up.
You know, Danny's one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. He's got a lot of things he wants to share with you. I'll see you guys later.
Yeah. Let's go. I'll get you to take a lap.
All right. That's cool.
Yep.
So what happened next?
So we're down 18, late in the third quarter. Got the guys in the huddle. I told them we're going to throw the ball on every play until we win the game.
What happened?
You ever heard of fake spike? So we got back to within three. On the Jets' 9-yard line, 22 seconds left. Defense screws up. I fake the spike. We win the game.
Wow.
Look, I'm not saying don't listen to your coaches, but sometimes you got to go back to what works on the playground. Like my father always said, you can't defend a perfect pass. Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Enough with the chit chat.
Okay. Sorry for the weird cut. You didn't miss anything, don't worry.
How about we see what you can do when you stop thinking and start trusting your gut?
Yes, sir.
Relax, you can call me Dan.
Okay, done.
Jack sent me a tape on you, and the one thing I like is you seem to want to stay in the pocket.
Oh, best to let my arm do the talking, sir.
Exactly, that's what I'm thinking. Anyway, let's have some fun. Hey, guys, let's bring it in. Are you guys good with a quick game of 7-on-7?
All right, let's go.
First team to 21 wins. 15 yards for a first down, 4 seconds
to get
rid of the ball.
Jerseys
and the quarterback can't cross the line of scrimmage. Get it?
The fit.
Hey, coach, am I playing defense?
Sure, I think it'll be good for you to see the field from the safety spot.
The coloring on them.
All right.
The color scheme.
Here we go. All right, let's go out there and have some fun, all right? Let's go.
All right, 7-on-7 rules. First team to score 21 points will win. 15-yard first downs. QB must release the ball within 4 seconds. QB cannot pass the line of scrimmage. Passing plays only. Interceptions called dead. No special teams plays. Special teams plays. Okay. All right, let's get it. I love this beat. Get in there. Oh, he dropped it. This dude dropped it. Get in. Ah. Did he get it? No, I don't think he held on to it. Oh, he almost intercepted it. Oh. Dang it, man. I just killed that dude. Oh, where's... There he is. So it's like two-hand touch. I got it. Oh. I hate that the... God, if I could run it, it'd be great, but I'm not allowed. Dang. That's what's up.
Nice touch, D.
That defense. Yeah, he's gonna run this way. 3rd and 15. Two more, guys. Two more. Right, two more stops. Yeah, there we go. Hurry up, Yeah, let's get it. Got kicked, even though he probably didn't.
Boom! Can't teach that, Deb. Perfect throw.
More or less. Alright. Oh no! Hold on to the ball! Gotta hold on to the ball, dude! Incomplete. Lockdown corner. Oh lord. We got a whole bunch of receivers this time. Nice. Alright, it's first to 21, so all we gotta do is, if we can get a stop here, we can score. Did he catch it? Nope. Alright, let's get it. One more. Come on, get it. Yeah! Let's get it. Alright. Oh, what's this? This is different.
It's gonna be a tight throw. Gotta get it just right.
Ah! Oh my. Oh my. Oh, turn! I didn't expect it to just, okay. Oh goodness. Yeah. Okay, sorry for that weird cut. Oh, got it. Yeah!
Yes! Nice throw! Wade takes it.
job, guys.
See, I told you. Just relax, have fun, let the game come to you.
Yeah, I definitely felt more comfortable than I have in a long time.
See, there's very few quarterbacks who are born with the talent that you have. All you have to remember is why you fell in love with the game.
Okie dokie, so the Legends game is on the schedule where it belongs. Final episode before the NFL draft. But I want to talk to you about the next episode. We initially planned to visit a military base, and I still think it's a great idea for the show. But I wanted to ask if you think it's best if you stayed here to study.
I'll do it.
Really?
Yeah, but on one condition.
U.S. military base in Dubai.
At ease, Wade. It's good to see you, son.
Oh, you took care.
How's the flight?
Oh, you know,
an easy 18 hours. And you brought this gentleman along?
Dan Marino, sir.
Yeah, I know. I grew up in Jersey. You broke the Jets' hearts every time I turn on the television. You must be Julia.
Thanks for having us, Captain McCarthy.
Oh, my pleasure. You know, Devin is a darn fine carpenter, but it is way more fun to watch him run around on TV than it is watching him cut wood.
Colton Cruz.
I'm also on the show.
Okay.
I bet you are.
8,000 miles from home, and it was this place that brought you back to football.
I'll field that one. You don't mind?
Please.
Steve, I knew who Devin was. Now, I don't know if the other guys knew, but when he got here, he was reclusive. Always had his head down. So a year or so in, I decided to give him a little push. So I hid these footballs around here. There. What did he ever take the bait?
Is that true?
It's funny you ask, Dan the man. Because I can show you.
So he actually lived in the Middle East. Okay. I thought that was just the Mario being a jerk or something. I don't know.
You see, Dan would build these crates and then smash them up. You want to show him?
Help me out. Let's do it.
Battalion Captain.
Okay.
Well, I actually know a little something about regret. See, I was a kicker in college, and my junior year we're playing in the Sugar Bowl. And I missed 3 field goals. It lost us the game. I couldn't face my teammates. I couldn't even face the fans. So, I quit. Just convinced myself I wasn't any good. A year later, I graduated and came here. You can't undo your own mistakes. Maybe you can help others avoid making theirs.
Okay, so it's 7 points for the deep ones, 5 for the middle, 3 for the ones up close.
Cole, you want to keep score?
Yes, sir.
All right, score as many points as possible before the timer runs out. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Show me how it's done.
Asked for
it. Fun now.
Nice.
You made me nervous. There you go. Why are you just warming up? That was perfect debut. Do it all day. Just watch.
Oh my goodness.
Oh no.
The tempo, that was a little wobble.
No!
All right, everybody. Dan Marino takes the win.
Best 2 out of 3?
I got a better idea.
Okay, guys, so I think we're going to end it here. losing my balance. Alright, so I hope y'all enjoy the video. Have an awesome day, Wolfpack.